With the famous brown briefcase, Matia Kasaija, the Minister of Finance, was already at Kololo by 2 p.m. to present the breakdown of the 52.7 trillion shillings budget for the financial year 2023-2024 and its implementation. This time, it was the Vice President Jessica Alupo that officiated physically, while the President attended virtually via Zoom. In her speech, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, decried limited financing of local governments, which has stagnated at 11% of the total budget for the last 10 years. The Speaker, among others, noted that underfunding has also limited the capacity of local governments to mobilize local revenue.
The budget of the local government is insufficient to adequately stimulate the desired growth envisaged under the fiscal decentralization strategy.
The Speaker also cited bottlenecks affecting implementation of the parish development model and called on government to address the challenges.
Should work together to ensure that the PDM becomes a success, since we are putting a lot of money in PDM.
In the budget, 1.1 trillion shillings has been allocated to full-scale implementation of the parish development model. Kasaija noted that a total of 590.2 billion shillings has been disbursed since PDM was launched.
Since the launch of the PDM in February 2022, a total of shillings 590.2 billion has been disbursed to all the 10,459 parishes nationwide, translating into shillings 50 million per parish. The balance will be disbursed by end of this month. Next financial year, the parish development model has been allocated 1.1 trillion Uganda shillings.
Government has committed to resolve the plight of medical interns and senior house officers by providing 22.6 billion shillings to clear outstanding arrears in 2 weeks' time. Government projects are to create over 2.5 million jobs in the next 5 years, starting with this budget. This will be achieved by implementing the parish development model, industrialization, wealth creation, and full monetization of the economy.
These SMEs will access new and innovative financing products with long-term financing of up to 15 years. This intervention aims at increasing Uganda's manufactured export products, grading and classification of tourism facilities. Shillings 249 billion has been allocated for the promotion of our tourism.
Government has allocated 4.5 trillion shillings, representing 13.3% of the total budget. This will go to road maintenance and construction, railway development and rehabilitation, water and air transport development. 16 national road projects are to be completed, including Atiak-Laropi, Moroto-Lotkanyara, Kauku-Weranga, among others.
The road sector in 1986 totaled 97,100 kilometers. Today, it has expanded 20-fold to almost 160,000 kilometers, while only 6,700 kilometers of today's road network is paved. The road network now allows access to even the remotest part of Uganda.
8.1 trillion shillings this financial year has been allocated to security, governance, the legislature, and the administration of justice. 447 billion shillings has been allocated to fast-track the development of petroleum resources in the next financial year. Public debt is projected to shoot up to 88.9 trillion shillings by the end of this month, June 2023. equivalent to $23.7 billion by 30th June 2023. Uganda's public debt stood at 80.8 trillion shillings, equivalent to $21.7 billion as of December 2022. In summing up the budget speech, Kasaija made it clear that there will be no purchase of new vehicles for political leaders and public officers in the next financial year. Travel abroad has also been restricted to statutory functions and for critical legal and resource mobilization functions. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.